I first met Charles Parker at the gynecologist's office. She could tell I was nervous, so she talked to me. At first, I was annoyed, but then it started working. She's a student from Asheville, studio art, which I had to Google. She works part-time in a bike shop. I haven't been on a bike in forever.
I could tell she was maybe kinda Christian, but she seemed like one of the nice ones, so I thought, cool. She's married, and she seemed happy enough. She does audiobooks, like records them, which I mean, how long does that take? Fuck. Anyway, a couple of weeks later, I was dropping off a bike in Lincoln Square, and she was sitting on a park bench.
I thought it was so funny that we ran into each other again, but that's God for ya. We talked about her art and my church. I told her my favorite time of day was my daily devotional every morning. I invited her to come over and join me sometime, not really thinking what that meant. It's private and so early, and she's not even a believer.
I haven't hung out with, like, a Christian in a long time, but it's cool. Nice place. So, this is where the magic happens.
Yep, I sit here with my tea and my Bible, and I have a daily devotion app on my phone that's taking me through the whole thing.
The whole Bible?
Slowly but surely, yeah.
Jesus.
Yes, he comes in midway through.
So, what do you do now?
Oh, you mean if I were...
Yeah, like if I weren't here, what would you be doing right now?
Well, I would make my tea, and I would come in and sit down, and I'd probably just look out the window, express my gratitude for the day.
That's nice. Shall we?
Are you done?
Oh. Yeah, no, I'm done.
And then I would open my little app on my phone and remind myself of the scripture for the day.
What we got?
Romans 12.
Sounds biblical.
Oh, are we gonna...
Yeah, that's the whole reason I'm here, right?
Oh, but are you really interested?
Yes!
Oh, he sleeps forever. He's a lazy butt. But anyway, I don't want to bore you.
Libby, I'm into this.
Yeah?
Yes. Now, let's do our thing. Our thing.
Our morning devotion.
Our morning devotion. I like this.
Okay. I like this too. Okay. Romans 12, verses 1 through 21.
Great.
Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Should I keep going?
Yeah, for sure.
Am I sitting okay? I mean, is where I'm
what?
And how I'm sitting, is this okay?
Keep going.
For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you.
Can I stop you?
Yes.
The faith God has distributed to each of you. I thought you were supposed to have faith on your own. Like that was the point of having faith.
Hmm.
You know?
It gets into predestination, Calvinism, which is its own debatable thing.
Like fatalism. Like God chooses who chooses him.
Well, when you put it like that, it sounds awful, but yes.
Well, something to chew on?
Absolutely.
Carry on, darling.
For just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ we, though many, form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts according to the grace given to each of us. If your gift is prophesying, then prophesy
in accordance with your... Prophesying?
Yes.
I mean, he just says it like it's no big deal, prophesying. I mean, have you ever met somebody with the gift of prophecy?
No.
Okay, I'm just checking.
I did once, when I was little, meet a preacher who told us that a storm was coming, and then a week later, my family and I got caught in a storm on a boat. So, actually, yes.
Okay, fair enough.
If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, do it cheerfully.
I love that. Will you read that again?
If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. If it is to show mercy, then do it cheerfully.
What's your gift?
Oh, wow. I do like to serve. I hope that I show mercy.
You do.
How do you know?
I don't know. Maybe I feel it.
What's yours? I think that you're an encourager. I feel encouraged by you.
Yeah, maybe so.
Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil, cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction.
Be patient in affliction.
Faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality.
Hey, that's you.
I am practicing, yes. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse.
I have a little bit of an issue with that one, but we can get to that later.
I can explain. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited.
That's really good advice.
Yes. Do not repay anyone evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everyone. If it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my dear friends, but leave room for God's wrath. Mm. For it is written, "It is mine to avenge, I will repay," says the Lord.
Well, that took a turn.
If your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will heap burning coals on his head.
What?
Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
And that's that.
And that is that.
You know, I'm actually pretty down with most of that. That was really lovely.
Yeah, that was a good one. I'm glad that you came into my life now and not during Revelation.
Oh.
That would have been...
Yikes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yikes.
Scary. Not good.
So what do you do now?
Well, on the devotional app, there's usually a little addendum a devotional passage that accompanies the scripture, but they're usually really cheesy.
Try me.
No, I'm not. I'm not reading that.
Come on!
Nope.
Okay, cool.
It's better to just stick to the scripture.
All that phase three slide for today.
Thanks.
And now?
And then I just sit here and I think about what I've read and I meditate on it for a bit. I finish my tea. And then I pray.
Okay.
Lord, thank you for Charles. Thank you for sending me my new friend not once but three times. I so appreciate the blessing of being able to share my quiet time with her today. Give us both the strength and the grace to tackle the days ahead. Thank you for our lives. I love you. In your name, amen.
Amen. I think the only time I've ever had, like, a real spiritual experience was when I was in high school. When the weather was good, my drama teacher would take us all outside, and we'd have to go from seeds in the ground to a full-grown plant. So we'd start off in these little balls on the ground, and then she would tell us to start absorbing the light and the sun and the life and the day, and then we just kind of grow into ourselves. I think that's the only time I've ever felt like a soul and not just a body.
Hmm. Well, that's nice.
Do you want to try it?
Sure.
Okay, so first you start on the ground in like a little ball, like completely tight and wound up. Okay? Okay. Go on. So, and then you just start absorbing the sunlight, and then you just grow into a thing, a full-grown thing.